There's so many inventive and brilliant kids around the world, but they don't have access to proper information and proper textbooks. They could learn more about the topics that they're interested in. So our idea was to create an electronic book so that we could store basically all the books in the Library of Congress, for instance, on a single ebook. How do we produce that at very low cost? That was really our goal. Instead of just printing books or newspapers the way Gutenberg did, we actually manufacture electronics by printing. So the idea behind e-ink is that we have little nanoparticles that have charges on them, and we can put an electric field and we can change their position and create an image on the sheet of the paper. This is a piece of e-ink that was addressed electronically almost 10 years ago and still retains its image today. This is our very first product that we ever created that has all the properties we were looking for, something that looks like paper, visible in bright sunlight, and very, very long battery life. The idea for e-ink came out of the MIT Media Lab. And one of the great things about MIT is we have a big emphasis on spinning that technology out. And so we created a company called e-ink. We have more than 150 US patents and many international patents. Here are some of the things that we're working on right now. Very, very flexible displays. Things that have the ability to withstand breakage and potentially much cheaper as well. There's so many brilliant kids all around the globe. Being able to put an entire library in their hands gives them the tools to be inventors, create brand new things for the benefit of the entire world. That to me is a really exciting thing. It's a tremendous privilege to be able to go from an idea that one has initially to products and devices that are in millions of people's hands. And hopefully these few drops of electronic ink can really have a tremendous positive benefit on learning.